This is butter. These are eggs frying in butter. This is cheese. Some seasonings. Some onions. Fold it over. This is an omelet. Any questions?
You see? You see? Your stupid minds! Stupid! Stupid!
I have waited so long for this.
So have I.
With all the radio stations around, all the music being shoved at you all day long, you need a break. You need a change from the hard-driving, catchy tunes that those other stations play. But we're WZZZ, all bland radio. At WZZZ, we don't play songs you've heard again and again. We don't play songs by people with names too difficult to pronounce, or reputations too filthy to discuss with your family. We don't even play songs with lyrics, drum beats, or melodies. We're anonymous rock music. We're WZZZ. Music to fall asleep to.
Oh, dear Lord Jesus, this ain't happening, man. This can't be happening, man. This isn't happening.
What?
As the latter part of the 20th century draws to a close, our world shrinks to indeed a global village. The video image is piped into every nook and cranny of this tiny planet. Cable is everywhere. But in this electronic age, there still remains one town that isn't touched by the magic wand of cable access. Until now. Now this small community too could bask in 24-hour stock car racing, all-night movies, and the Weather Channel. Yes, the high-tech modern world had finally caught up with this small town. The wizards of the cathode ray had finally arrived. And to celebrate this breakthrough, the whole town changed their name. Never mind who they used to be. Just call them Cableville. Cableville, USA.
Good evening and welcome to another edition of Rock Rap. I'm Scott St. Scott, sitting in here for Bruce Rooster Cogburn, who's out on a little sick leave, but he'll be back next week rapping with all the rock stars that make rock rap what it is. Tonight, I'm rapping with a rock star, a very, very special man. He was on the front cover of Rolling Stone magazine last week, and he deserves to be there. He, of course, is the dishwasher to the stars. Please give me a hand in welcoming Cincy Smith Mugrum to the studio.
Oh, thanks. Stop it.
How you doing, Sense? I'm telling you, I'm very excited to be sitting next to the man who has virtually cleaned up the rock and roll business.
Yes, I've been around, you know, I've done everything. You know, since the 60s, I've been around since actually about 57.
57. So you were there when Dick Clark was first introducing your Del Shannons and your Little Richards to
the music
scene.
I've cleaned up after both of them.
And how were they?
The Richards. They were all right. They were quite nice, quite gentlemanly. You know, it was the 50s. Everyone was in the short hair, nice guys. You know,
nice guys. And then sort of rock and roll broke out into the 60s. And
oh, yes, the Nasty Boys, you know, the Stones and the Beatles, you know. Them.
Well, tell us about the Stones. You've mentioned in the article in Rolling Stone that Keith Richards was one of the messiest people you've ever had to clean up for.
The messiest, I'd say.
The messiest.
The messiest, I'd say. Because, see, what he'd do, he'd have a plate, roast beef, potatoes, mashed potatoes, peas, you know, something like that. He'd take his gravy, put it in a little reservoir, cut it, and then the reservoir, it'd spill down into the peas, into the beef, and then he'd put out a cigarette in it, you know?
Right into the plate.
Right, yeah, oh yes.
Would he see, this would be after he was done, or he would continue to eat it at that point?
No, he wouldn't eat much, you know, you see how thin he is, you know what I mean? He'd just eat a nibble, little push, cigarette, and then he'd leave it for, 6 hours, you know,
six,
and get hard, crusty.
And then you, of course, would have to remove it from the plate.
Right.
At some point.
Yes.
Do you ever think of just, I don't know, buying new dishes and slipping them in once in a while on the
guy? Yes, I did it a little bit, you know, with, what's his name, Keith Moon?
He used to...
Actually, he would just throw them in the wall, throw them across the room, throw them through a TV set, you know, it'd be, you know, hard to retrieve, except that Melmac stuff, you know, that Corelware.
Oh, yeah, that doesn't
break. You can do
it. Yeah, now that we're, as long as you bring up Corelware, I understand that you have your own line of dishes coming
out.
Sponsored by the Corelware people.
Yes, oh, yes, you knew that.
I did, I was brief before. Where we went on with the show, I've got Bruce's notes.
They're quite nice. I got my little name is Sensi. Sensiware.
Sensiware.
Yeah.
That sounds great. Well,
you can't break them, you know what I mean? I mean, you know, what's her name? Ann Wilson from Heart could sit on them. Nothing would happen.
Not even Ann Wilson.
That's part of our ad, actually. She sits on the plate.
On the plate. Right. In black and black outfit, no doubt.
Yes, she's a little weird.
Oh, this is great. Well, I am excited to be sitting next to you here, finding out about the stars and what they eat. I'll do my best. We've got gentlemen, though, and people from all across the country who are just as anxious as I am to ask you a few questions about the stars.
Well, bring them in.
They're on phones. Just calling in. This is a sort of a low-budget show.
Hook them up.
We're going to hook them right up. Our first caller is Ishtar Shapur, and he's listening, or watching, rather, on WHIO in Dayton, Ohio. Ishtar, are you there?
Hello, are you there?
We're here. Have you got a question for Sensi Smith Mugram, dishwasher to the stars?
Yes, I have. I have a very important question for Sensi. Sensi, I am a dishwasher. I wash dishes and small plates in a Denny's in Ohio. And what I want you to know is, how do I come from a dishwasher in Ohio to dumb a dishwasher to the start? Please tell me that.
That is a good question. Sensi, have you got any advice for Ishtar?
Well, from Denny's, I'd say Baker's Square. Immediately.
Yeah, as far as a step-by-step progress
right. Green card's probably the first thing you want. And then Baker's Square. And then, you know, it's real simple. It's who you know, not what you know exactly, because, you know, washing dishes is an art, you know, but it's not, you know.
So you don't just wash for anyone. You find out who's important, and you wash for them.
You get yourself a small local band, somebody, you know, and you wash their dishes. And then a politician, somebody, you know, has connections, you know. And there's three things you want to remember. Hot water, rubber gloves, always wear rubber gloves. In fact, I've got an emollient in here right now. It's quite squishy. And keep yourself clean. Clean living. You know what I mean? Stay away from the bleaches and the limeaways and
stuff. Say no to bleach.
Say no to bleach.
Of course.
You young people out there, you know, just stay away from bleaches. And a lot of, joint lubricant. Joint lubricant, you know what I mean?
Elbow grease.
And you do the counterclockwise. Stay away from the counterclockwise motion. It just doesn't work as well because of the upstroke. I don't know. You know, it's aerodynamics or something.
Well, there you go, Ishtar. Three big tips from the man who knows how to wash dishes. Does that help you out?
Oh, that makes me very much more happy. Thank you very much, Zenzi.
That's wonderful.
Keep your eyes pointed up at the stars.
You know, I've got a question. Do you have any particular kind of detergent that you feel is better than another kind of detergent? Something we can tell our people to stick with.
You're soaking in it.
That's your favorite.
Yes, I like
it. I noticed there was a big blackballing thing in the mid-60s.
It was emollient wars, we called it, you know. There's a lot of different, it's a harsh bleach, you know. It was bleach is what it was in the old days.
And you kept yourself clean through all that time, so to speak, and you're here to live to tell about it.
Yes, there's a lot of people I know that just got caught up in that, and they jumped out a window or something. You know what I mean?
Well, listen, let's get on to our next caller. We've got a gentleman here, Alan Franklin. He's calling in from WCCC in Minneapolis. Are you there, Alan?
Hello? Hello, am I there?
I don't know, Alan, are you?
I'm there. Thanks.
It's great to hear from you. Have you got a question for Cincy Smith today?
Yeah, I got a question for Cincy. Cincy, I've heard this is true, that you were the only dishwasher at Woodstock. Is that true?
Good point.
Well, yes, it was. It was
the only dishwasher?
It was a mix-up. There was at least 10 other dishwashers that were supposed to be there, and they figured, you go, it's a concert in a big farm up in New York, you know what I mean? They went to Jersey to do some wedding or something, and they didn't go. And so I was the only one there. They said, we'll meet you there. Ha, ha, ha. And now there I was. So I washed up after.
So you wore in quite a few calluses that weekend.
Oh, God, yes. It was a three-day fest. I think the dishes took about 2.5 weeks to finish up.
God, well, you worked for just about everyone who would soon to become a big
star
that day.
It was a big coup for me, that and Live Aid, because Joplin didn't eat.
Drinking the whole time.
Right, Sean and I were pizzas mostly, pepperoni and green peppers.
Well, the Who were at that concert.
The Who, that's where I got to know Keith Moon, and like I said, he broke all his dishes, And Richie was a pig, what I mean? Spaghetti. He'd leave the spaghetti in a bowl, get crusty.
Oh, hard to get off. Hard to get off. So the entire Woodstock by yourself, what a coup. Now, you've been to Live Aid, and you're also, as far as big concerts coming up, you're doing Comic Relief, is that
right.
correct?
Right, doing Comic Relief 3. I did 1, 2, and now 3.
Can you tell me about Robin Williams?
Well, Robin Williams, the oddest thing, he doesn't actually order food. He doesn't eat any of his own food. He just nibbles off everybody else's. He just steals a bit steals a bit there from Whoopi.
I've heard that was a rumor, and I wanted to confirm it with the man.
A lot of the
know.
Lesser comics will, lesser in stature in the pecking order, will order something nice, like a beef stroganoff.
And something with some meat to it.
Right, he'll take the meat. He'll go, you just need noodles, and he'll just take the meat.
Take the meat.
And he'll go over to Whoopi and take a sprout or something. And have a big plate.
I'd heard that was true, but I didn't want to believe it till I heard it from the horse's mouth. Hey, listen, Cincy, it's been great to have you on the show. Whoop.
Oh, watch your hands.
Rubber gloves.
Watch it.
You must have those insured, huh?
Oh, yes. The gloves?
Yeah, no, the hands.
Oh, the hands, yes. All the hands, yes. I throw the gloves out.
Oh, that's wonderful. Well, it's been great talking to the dishwasher, to the stars. Let's just hope, you see nothing but clean plates in your future.
Thanks.
Thanks a lot. I'm Scott St. Scott, sitting in this week for Bruce Rooster Pod, working on Rock Rap. We'll be back again next week, rapping with the rock stars and rock and roll. Thanks for tuning in.